Welcome to the introduction to the Daktronics Show Control System. This video will give a brief summary of all the features of the Show Control software. Follow along on screen or on your own Show Control computer as we explore the program. Daktronics Show Control is a powerful user-friendly control software interface. Show Control works in conjunction with the other hardware components, including the DMP7000 that runs Zenit 7000 and the DMP8000 that runs Zenit, as well as others. The Show Control computer operates over an Ethernet computer network to control what the audience sees on the displays. Show Control consists of two separate programs, Display Studio and Content Studio. Display Studio is used to trigger content to the displays during an event, while Content Studio is used as a content compositor prior to an event. Launch Display Studio by clicking on the desktop icon, which looks like an orange and gray cube. When Display Studio launches, you're taken into a workspace. Users can create multiple workspaces if desired. This is helpful for venues that are home to multiple sports teams so that operators don't interfere with each other's workspaces. In the upper left corner, we have the hub, or the file menu, where common menu items are accessed. These items include new, open, save, close, and help. You will also see custom options such as assigned service configuration setting and software license details. The monitor wall allows users to see content playing out to the various displays and windows. This is not a real-time playback, but rather a sampling of the content being played to each display over the computer network. The large space in the middle section of the screen holds the containers. There's two types of containers, scripting and quick display. Buttons are made by the user and are placed in these containers for easy access during an event. In the lower left corner of the screen is the status indicator. This offers quick diagnosis of software issues and serves as a first step in troubleshooting situations. Clicking in the status light will reveal a window with helpful information in correcting the problem with the signal flow. Widgets at the bottom of the screen allow for quick on-the-fly control of items such as dimming the display and adjusting the audio. Your system may not contain all the same widgets shown here because of the nature of the system. The DSTI widget is common for systems that have STAT integration, but may not be found in all configurations. This concludes the Display Studio portion of this video. Let's move now to the Content Studio side of the software. To access Content Studio, click on the pencil icon in the top right-hand corner of your screen. Notice there is no open file and most of the options are unavailable. The hub in the upper left corner contains common functions including new, open, save, as well as a batch conversion tool and the options for Content Studio. For the purposes of this video, let's create a new file by selecting New. When creating a new file or opening an existing one in Content Studio, the New Presentation wizard box will appear. Select Display. The next step lists all of the available displays and windows. Choose the display or window you are creating content for. Once a new file is set up, the screen will look similar to this. Along the top are basic function tabs that bring up several different options within this upper ribbon. The layout is seen on the right side of the screen. This represents the display or display window. The Home tab has basic functions including font, layout, and paragraph properties. It also is the home for quick inserts like media items and text boxes. Under the Insert tab, you'll find options for inserting a picture, video, text box, or real-time data such as time and date. Note that only systems that have a temperature sensor installed can use the temperature option. The Format tab contains fill colors, gradient options, borders, and alignment and layering options. Transitions between layouts are found under the Layout tab. You can hover over each of these to see a brief description of each one. Finally, the View tab has zoom buttons and preview controls. You may also notice that these same controls are also located in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen for easy access. Located on the left side of the screen is the Dynamic Data Library. It's used to place real-time data, or RTD, such as statistics, on the layout. This feature is primarily used in sports venues where other stat software is installed. We'll demonstrate the use of this feature in later videos. The timeline across the bottom shows a visual representation of the length of the project layout, as well as all the elements that the layout contains, similar to that of video editing software. The timeline has a dedicated zoom bar to get a closer or a broader look at the timing of the elements. The Layout Storyboard tab provides a different view of the layout. Adding multiple layouts to a single presentation creates different frames or slides with content. The hourglass represents where a transition effect would be added if desired. This concludes the Show Control System overview. Continue to other videos to learn more about your Daktronics display control system.